Good morning, ma'am. If I could have you raise your right hand.
Right.
Do you swear the testimony you're to give in this proceeding is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth under the pains and penalties of perjury?
I do.
If you'd have a seat and state your full name and spell your last name for the record.
My full name is Nan Beatrice Nutt. First name N-A-N, last name Nutt, N-U-T-T.
And Ms. Nutt, if you just hand me that little folder there, I think that was meant to be, yes. I think that was meant to be given back.
Thank you, Judge.
Yes. Attorney Speicher.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Ms. Nutt, where do you live?
One moment. I forgot to put hearing aids in, so I will need you to speak up.
I will speak up. Can you hear me now?
I can.
Thank you. Ms. Nutt, where do you live?
I live on at 149 East Side Drive, Concord.
How long have you lived here in Concord?
Slightly more than 3 years.
Okay. And before that, generally speaking, where did you live?
I lived in Seacoast, New Hampshire, Dover, Epping.
Thank you. Ms. Nutt, could you please tell the jury about your educational background?
I'm trained at the PhD level as an immunologist in a medical school microbiology department. So I sort of have areas of expertise in both microbiology and immunology.
Could you tell us what degrees you have?
I have a bachelor's degree in genetics, a master's and a PhD also, both from the medical school.
Thank you. And Ms. Nutt, could you tell us a little bit about your career and what sort of work you did?
The first part of my career was working in laboratories in a number of different locations in immunology research. And then I transitioned into computer science, not as a developer, but as an application specialist primarily and a writer. And particularly, or my favorite job in computer science was working with a group that did molecular modeling of molecules, proteins, antibodies in particular was my favorite, because that's, of course, part of immunology.
That sounds wonderful. I don't understand a word of it. Ms. Nutt, are you currently retired?
I am.
For how long have you been retired?
12 years.
Ms. Nutt, I'd like to ask you now about April 18th of 2022. Do you remember that day?
I do.
Okay. Ms. Nutt, what did you do on April 18th of 2022?
Relative to this proceeding, I went to hike with my two dogs, who are both fairly small, on the Marsh Loop Trail.
Okay, I'd like to ask you about your dogs. What sort of dogs are they?
They're both rescue dogs. We know a little bit about them. They had belonged to my friends, both of whom have passed. One of them is a mixed poodle, about 16 to 18 pounds, and one of them is a larger, unknown mix. He's about 24 pounds. The only information I have is that his father was a big black dog, but I can pick him up.
Was it common for you, or is it common for you to go on walks with your dogs?
Yes, absolutely. Every day, three times a day, one way or the other, we get out.
Great. And so you mentioned that you went hiking with your dogs that day on the Marsh Loop Trail. Is that right?
Correct.
Okay. Could you just generally for the jury describe what is the Marsh Loop Trail?
It's part of a group of trails called the Broken Ground Trails. They are within about 10 minutes of where I live. There are a number of trails that intersect. The Marsh Loop Trail is somewhat like what it sounds like. It circles around a marshy area of that trail system.
Prior to April 18th of 2022, had you hiked the Marsh Loop Trail or any of the Broken Grounds trails before?
I've hiked all of the broken ground trails, and I think there are four or five of them now. And I enjoyed especially hiking the Marsh Loop Trail when I was with the dogs, because I kept them on leashes, but they were extendable leashes, and I preferred not to encounter other people because it tended to wrap the leashes around other folks.
Okay. So prior to April 18th, had you taken your dogs on the Marsh Loop Trail?
Yes, but I don't know how often, and it probably hadn't done, if I had done one earlier that spring, it was because it was early spring, that would have been just one time.
Okay. Ms. Nutt, if you could look behind you there on the wall, I'm showing you what for the record is already marked as State's Exhibit 75. Do you recognize what's shown there on the wall?
I do.
And what is that?
That's a map of the trails, of the broken ground trails that the Conservation Commission puts out.
And is this, does the Marsh Loop Trail show up on this map?
Oh, yes, it does. Okay. It's labeled, actually.
Great. And that's the trail that we've been talking about so
yes.
far, right?
Yes.
Thank you. And now I'm going to show you one other thing here that's also already marked as State's Exhibit 225. Is this a calendar showing April of 2022? It's not
that's what it says, so I guess it is.
If this helps, do you remember it was Monday? It was April 18th, a Monday?
I have to be honest, I don't remember whether it was a Monday or a Tuesday, but I do know the weather was nice, so we could check against the weather that day.
Okay. When you went to the Marsh Loop Trail on April 18th, how did you get there?
I drove to a small parking lot just off of Portsmouth Road, and which is where the large utility poles, an area where there's a utility line, I parked there and started in on the trail there.
Just generally for the jurors, could you describe what the trail is like when you start at the parking lot that you described?
It's not that way now, but at the time I was hiking it was heavily overgrown brush, but no trees. There was one fairly soggy area, which I think they have now put some boards across so that you don't have to walk in the mush. But it was pretty overgrown bushes at the time.
Ms. Nutt, do you remember what the weather was like that day?
Beautiful sunny day. Cool spring. Not cold, just cool.
And so I think you mentioned this. You had your two dogs with you, is that right?
Correct.
And were they both on leashes?
They were both on leashes.
Was there anyone else with you for your hike that day?
No.
Do you remember about what time you began your hike?
Sometime after 2 o'clock, probably getting close to 3.
Did you have anything that you had later in the day by way of an appointment?
I did. That's why I'm saying where I think the time was. I had a 4 o'clock rehearsal back at Havenwood Heritage Heights where I live that I wanted to get back to, but I wanted to do this hike first.
And so when you went for the hike, which trail did you take that day?
I took the Marsh Loop Trail. The one, oops, gone. Oh, well, it's in yellow on the map.
I can bring it back up for you.
It's a little hard to tell because some of those colors, I think, look the same. But I think the little parking lot is marked on that map.
Okay. And so you mentioned you took the Marsh Loop Trail that day. Was there any particular reason you selected the Marsh Loop Trail that day?
Because it's easy to get in and out of in the sense of parking, and because there aren't a lot of people on that trail, or at least compared to some of the other pieces of this group of trails.
Ms. Nutt, using the map, could you describe when you started your hike, did you go in a clockwise direction or a counterclockwise direction from the parking lot?
Clockwise.
Thank you. After you started your hike, did you see any other people on the trail?
I did. Do you want me to expound on that?
Yes, please.
Tell you more.
Please tell us more.
We were probably just a few minutes in, maybe as much as 5 minutes in, and I heard a couple, or at least what I thought was a couple, because they were talking to one another, coming up behind me. And the trail is fairly narrow, partly because of the bushes and just it is narrow, and I thought it would be polite to step off so that because we meaning myself and the dogs are pretty slow. The dogs sniff, 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 sniff everything. So I did step off with the dogs, and these folks went past me.
Could you describe what they looked like?
Um, white male, medium height, and a black female who was somewhat shorter. And I would have put them in their, I'm not very good at guessing ages, but I would have put them probably in their late 50s to late 60s.
What were they doing when they walked by you?
Talking to one another. I could hear them talking as they came up behind me, very comfortable conversation, and they continued talking. They did not speak to me. The man nodded as they went by. That was it.
Did they appear to be dressed in any particular way?
Don't remember what they were wearing, but they seemed to be appropriately dressed for what they were doing.
At that time, when you saw them, had you ever seen those people before?
I had not.
And so I think you said that when they passed you, you moved aside with your dogs to let them pass.
Yes.
Ms. Nutt, could you describe, generally speaking, where on the Marsh Loop Trail were you when those two people passed you?
In the very first section on that map, before the trail cuts to the right slightly to go up the hill.
So at the location where they passed you, were you in the open area under the power lines?
We weren't under the power lines, but we were to one side of the power lines.
Okay. So was it a cleared area?
You can call it clear, but we had to step into the bushes.
I
so
understand.
It depends on the definition. There are no trees, but there's lots of bushes.
Okay. Did you say anything to those people when they passed you?
No.
What happened after they passed you?
They kept walking, and we kept walking. I always refer to it as we, because I'm talking about myself and the two dogs. We all kept walking, started walking again.
Were they going faster than you?
Considerably faster, yes.
Could you tell us, Ms. Nutt, about how fast do you think you were going with your dogs when you were on your walk that day?
I would not have been able to estimate that at the time, but because I wear an Apple Watch and it was recording, I can pretty well say that it was under 2 miles an hour and with lots of stops and starts.
And are those stops and starts related to your dogs?
Yes. Not me. I don't usually stop and start unless they stop and start.
And you mentioned your Apple Watch, so I'll ask you now. Were you wearing your Apple Watch when you did your walk on Monday, April 18th?
I was.
And did you have your phone with you as well?
I did.
Okay. And do you ever use your phone and your watch to track your progress when you take walks?
I do.
Did you do that on April 18th?
I did.
And did you start that walk using your phone or your watch when you started the hike?
If I didn't actually at the car, it was very shortly after that.
Thank you. So, Ms. Nutt, you told us that this couple that you saw walked by you, traveling faster than you. Where did you see them go as they passed you?
For a little while, I couldn't see them at all. As we started on down the trail and the bushes were less dense, I saw them heading up the trail towards the woods.
Did you eventually see them enter the woods?
I did.
When you saw those two people enter the woods, could you say, if you can, about how far ahead of you were they?
This is a really very much an estimate, but I would say they were probably 200 yards ahead of me.
And again, if I ask you a question and you don't know the answer, please tell me.
I will.
I don't want you to fill in blanks.
Okay.
I appreciate that. So you saw them go into the hill or into the wooded area.
I did.
Did you continue walking with your dogs after they went into the wooded area?
I did.
Did anything happen after that?
I went on up the hill. And there's a marker that says Marsh Loops, and right at the woods. We went into the woods, and within a fairly short time, 3 to 5 minutes, or possibly a little more, but that's an estimate also, suddenly heard shots, very loud. All of us jumped, dogs and me.
Ms. Nutt, I'd like to ask you about that. You said you heard shots. Do you mean gunshots?
I am not much of a gun person, but my impression was that this was a gun, not a rifle, because they were higher pitch than I think of a rifle as being.
When you heard those shots, could you say how many shots you heard?
I heard 5.
Was there any particular rhythm or succession of those shots?
Yes. Bang, bang, slight pause, bang, bang, bang.
And did all of those shots happen, all 5, in very quick succession?
Very quick.
When you heard those shots, you said, were they very loud?
Very loud.
When you heard those shots, could you tell which direction they were coming from?
In front and off to the right from where we were.
Ms. Nutt, when you heard those shots, what did you think?
First thought was, I don't think it's hunting season. I didn't think there should be any hunting, and I didn't have any orange on me or the dogs. But then I thought, wait, it's April. Shouldn't be hunting now, as far as I knew. My next thought was, I've been watching too much awful TV.
Did those shots make you feel nervous?
Didn't make me feel, yes, the answer to that is yes.
So after hearing those shots and just feeling those emotions that you described, what did you do?
After I thought I've been listening to too much or watching too much bad TV, I decided time to walk on, and we did.
So Ms. Nutt, I'm gonna ask you another question, and this is one of those questions where please, if you don't know the answer, please let me know. Using that map that's up there on the wall, could you tell the jury about where you think you were on the trail when you heard those shots?
Can I stand up?
Absolutely. And I have a laser pointer too, if that
okay.
helps.
Okay, I think you're in the woods. I can't reach it.
Okay.
Right, so.
There's a pointer there if that would
this,
be helpful.
Does this work?
Yes, and that should be that top button. There we go.
Okay, let me take a so we were past, we probably were right about in here.
Okay.
Somewhere. We were in the woods already. Yeah, so you can see where it goes into the woods, maybe a little bit further south.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Nutt.
Whatever the direction that is.
So you mentioned that after hearing those shots, you ultimately decided to continue with your walk.
I did.
And did you continue walking the Marsh Loop Trail in the same direction?
I did.
As you continued to walk on the Marsh Loop Trail in that same direction, what, if anything, happened next?
We were on a section of the trail that is basically straight, so it would have been, again, a little bit north of this, going along here. And we saw a young man standing, looking to the right of the trail into the woods.
So, Ms. Nutt, when you say you saw a young man looking to the right, is that your right as you're traveling?
My right as I'm traveling on the trail, correct.
And so when you first saw that young man, was he on the trail?
He was on the trail, but looking in, yes, he was on the trail.
About how far away were you from that person when you first saw him?
Again, an estimate, 30 to 50 yards. I may have said less than that before. I'm not absolutely sure, but
just
close
asking you for what you remember, Ms. Nutt. We'll
I have to see what I originally said.
Okay, I think is a success. So Ms. Nutt does have a document with her.
Everybody has a copy of this.
I know.
Do you want to take it away from me?
No, I just want to have the discussion with counsel. If counsel
okay,
would
sorry.
Approach. No, you've done nothing wrong. You're good. You're good. I just wasn't aware that you all know that she.
Fine.
Just a lot of court rules. You mentioned that you saw a man on the trail looking off to your right into the woods.
Correct.
And you said that he was about 30 to 50 yards away from you when you first saw him?
Correct.
Could you please describe what that man looked like?
Medium height, medium build. Height meaning about 5'10". Not skinny, but slender. Do you want to know what he was wearing?
I'll ask you. Do you remember about how old he looked?
Oh, again, an estimate of 20s, mid-20s to early 30s.
Do you remember if he had a beard or if he was clean-shaven?
He was clean-shaven.
And do you remember, was he a white man?
White man.
Okay. Do you remember if he was wearing anything on his head?
That I have not been able to say for sure, whether he had a hat on of any kind.
So are you saying that you can't remember whether or not he had a hat, or you don't think he had a hat on?
I cannot remember whether or not he had a hat.
Okay. And Ms. Nutt, after first seeing this individual about 30 to 50 yards away from you, did you continue walking towards him?
I did.
Okay. I'll ask you some more about that, but eventually did you get closer to him?
I did.
Could you tell us what was he wearing?
He was in khaki pants and a navy blue sweatshirt, which might have been a hoodie, but I'm not sure about that. He had a day pack on his back that was black, and I think that's all I can remember.
Okay. You mentioned khaki pants. Do you mean the color or like the style of the pants?
The color. It was brown khaki.
Brown khaki. Do you remember, were those pants light brown or dark brown or any sort of...
I couldn't tell you without, if you had somebody standing in front of me, I might be able to say that's the shade. Otherwise, I can't say.
That's okay, and then thank you. You mentioned this man had a blue sweatshirt or hoodie on?
Navy blue.
Navy blue, is that dark blue?
Yes.
Was this person carrying anything in their hands?
Yes, he had a plastic single-use type grocery bag. It was brown, or the beige color that I think some store provides, but I couldn't tell you which one.
Okay.
A grocery store type bag.
A plastic shopping bag?
Yes.
Okay. And you said that it was brown or beige?
Light brown, beige.
Could you tell if there was anything in that shopping bag?
It looked heavy, so it looked like it was loaded. And as I came up closer, I could see some object sticking out sideways that looked like, to me, the top of something like a peanut butter jar.
Okay. Were you able to see with any particularity what that object was?
No.
Were you able to see what color that object was?
No.
And what makes you say that that bag was heavy?
Because bags like that tend to hang loose. This one was quite, I don't know how to describe it, it was full. So I think it was fairly heavy.
When you saw this person, what did you think?
My first thought was he heard the same thing, the same shots I heard.
Anything else?
I don't think that was the first thing I heard, but I did think he doesn't look like the normal, whatever that means, hiker or walker on this trail.
If you didn't think he looked like a normal hiker, did you think he looked like some other type of person?
Reminded me of people that I see around town who are what I call street people or homeless people.
Ms. Nutt, you mentioned that you saw him and you started to walk toward him. Could you please describe what happened as you continued to walk towards that person? What was he doing?
He continued to look into the woods for a while. He appeared to be staring, not scanning. His head was not moving. He was just staring straight ahead. And as I came fairly close, within 5 to 10 yards, he turned to look at me.
When he turned to look at you, did that make you feel any certain way?
Anxious.
And why was that?
I don't know. He just made me feel anxious. I think I had already determined that I didn't think he belonged on the trail, so that combination affected me.
As you approached this person, did you have your dogs with you?
Yes.
You mentioned that you have those dogs on retractable leashes, is that right?
Yes.
Did you have, were the dogs at, were those leashes out?
No, I brought them in short, as I do when I see any person on the trail.
Did you ultimately pass this person?
I did.
On which side did you pass him?
I passed him on my left.
So he was on your left as you passed him?
No, he was on my right. I was on the left.
Okay. Did you say anything to this person?
No.
Did he say anything to you?
No.
When he looked at you, how about how far away from him were you?
10 yards or more.
Okay. Did you look him in the eye?
I did not.
Why not?
Two reasons. One is I was raised to not, like most women of my age, you don't look a male that you don't know well, you don't look him in the face. And the other reason was he already made me uncomfortable.
After you passed him, did you continue walking?
I did.
I'm going to back up a little bit. From the point that you first saw this man to the point that you passed him, were you still walking at that slightly under 2 miles an hour pace that you described before?
Probably about the same pace, but because I brought the dogs in short on leashes, we moved along a little faster because they weren't able to stop and take a few sniffs.
After you passed this man and kept walking down the trail, what happened next?
Because he made me uncomfortable, I turned around to make sure that I knew what he was wearing. I was looking at his back, so that's what I did.
And why did you turn around
I turn around?
To look at him, yes.
Because he made me uncomfortable, and I thought, I ought to remember what this guy looks like.
When you turned around to look at him, what did you see?
A moment after I turned around, he turned around and looked at me. And then I turned around, back around, and kept walking.
Why did you do that?
Because I was not comfortable with having him looking at me.
Ms. Nutt, from the point that you first saw this man and walked by him to when he looked back at you and then you kept walking, did you notice anything on his clothes that seemed to be out of order? Any stains or markings on his clothes?
No, I did not see anything.
When you turned back to look at him and he was looking at you, who looked away first, I guess? Did you look away while he was still looking at you?
I think it was pretty close to simultaneous that he turned away and I turned away.
Could you see what he did after you turned away?
No, I started walking rapidly. Well, after, rapidly for us.
After you turned and started walking rapidly, did you look back again?
I think I looked back to confirm that he, in fact, was going the other direction. But that was a very brief look back.
Was he?
He was.
And how long after that first look back was that second look back?
Seconds.
After the interaction that you just described for us with that man that you saw on the trail, did you see him again?
I did not.
So after passing him and having that interaction, did you keep walking on the Marsh Loop Trail?
I did.
Did you eventually reach the intersection with the Knoll Trail?
I did.
And could you look on the map? Could you point out for the jury what color the Knoll Trail is?
Knoll Trail is in blue. Okay. It goes way up here in the background.
When you arrived at that intersection, did anything happen?
I encountered a man who was just coming off, and I think he was coming off this side of the trail, but I'm not absolutely sure. No, but coming off the Knoll Trail.
Okay. And did you have a conversation with that man?
I did. I stopped and spoke to him.
Okay. Without getting into what you spoke about, could you describe what that man looked like?
He was probably over 6 feet. He was gray. I think he had some kind of a bandana wrapped around his head. Also had some kind of a small pack on, and looked like he'd spent a lot of time on the trail.
Was he dressed like a hiker?
He was dressed like a hiker, and I can't remember any details about that, but He just seemed to be appropriately dressed for being a hiker or walker.
When you say gray, do you mean his hair?
He was, yes, I'm sorry. He was, his hair was gray, yes.
Could you say about how old did you think he was?
In his 60s.
Do you remember if he was wearing glasses or not?
Not sure.
Okay. And did that man make you feel uncomfortable?
No, he felt like he was a kind person.
About how long did you speak with that man?
A minute.
And just to be clear, was this a different person than the person that you saw on the trail earlier who was looking off to the right?
Absolutely.
After you spoke with him, with that second man near the intersection of the Noel Trail, what did you do next?
I continued on the Marsh Loop and finished the loop, went back to my car, got in, went home.
Okay. Do you remember about what time you finished the hike?
Quarter of four.
Did you make it back in time for your 4 o'clock appointment?
Barely.
Okay. Other than the man that you saw on the trail in the dark blue jacket who was looking, or sweatshirt, who was looking off to the right, and the man that you saw later up by the Noel Trail, did you see anyone else during your hike that day?
No.
At some point after April 18th, did you speak with the police?
I did.
Why did you do that?
My neighbor showed me an article from the paper about the couple that I had seen on the trail who were at that point missing.
And when you heard about that couple, what did you think?
What did I think? I thought that's the time to call the police because I knew I had seen them on the trail.
But did the couple that you saw, that your neighbor told you about, did you think those are the people I
saw? Oh, yes, I'm sorry. There was a picture in the article, and yes, it was absolutely the couple that I had seen.
And then did you ultimately call the police?
I did.
And was there a particular phone number you used to call them?
I don't remember.
Okay. Did you ultimately speak in person with anyone from the police?
I did.
Do you remember when that was?
Later on the day that I called.
And it was, yeah. Remember what day that was?
Thursday? No, I don't for sure.
Okay, that's fine. So you had that first conversation with the police officer, is that right?
Yes.
And was that a recorded interview?
Yes.
Did you later speak with another police officer after that?
Yes.
And was that with a detective named Wade Brown?
Yes.
Okay. Did you meet in person with Detective Brown?
Yes.
And was that week sometime?
I'm not absolutely clear on how quickly things happened. I don't know.
But at some point after calling the police, did you meet with Detective Brown?
Yes.
And when you met with him, did you give him your phone for the purpose of retrieving some data about your walk from your fitness
Yes.
app? Okay. Ms. Nutt, if you could, I'll do it this way. I'm showing you a photograph. Can you take a look at that?
Yes.
Do you recognize what that is?
I do. It's the information from my watch. I mean, my phone.
And is that a screenshot that was taken of your phone?
Yes.
At this time, Your Honor, I move to strike the ID on Exhibit 209.
Any objection?
No, Your Honor.
209 is a full exhibit.
So Ms. Nutt, if you could look up at the screen, is that the photograph you were just looking at?
Yes.
And is this the information from your phone about that hike on April 18th that we've spoken about?
Yes.
Okay. And on the left, is that some data about the hike?
Yes.
And then on the right, is that a map, generally speaking, of your route that day?
Yes.
Okay. And did you provide this information to the Concord police?
I did.
And in addition to giving those interviews, did you actually provide the police with a written statement?
I did.
Okay. Do you remember when you provided the police with that written statement?
Quite a bit later. Okay. The statement, that's it, quite a bit later.
Do you remember exactly when?
No.
I remember
the event, but I couldn't tell you what the date was.
Would looking at a copy of that statement refresh your memory as to when it was written?
Yes, I can look at it. I know when it was written. That was not when it was handed to police.
So I guess that was a bad question by me. Yeah. Do you remember when you wrote that statement?
I wrote that on the first pass on April 22nd. And then I did minor revisions on April 23rd.
And sometime after April 23rd, did you provide it to the Concord police?
I did.
And just looking at this again, this was the 22nd of Friday?
Yes.
Thank you.
If that's the correct calendar, yes.
One moment, please.
Absolutely.
Very quickly, Ms. Nutt, you mentioned some revisions to that statement. Were they major revisions?
No, I don't. Truthfully, I don't know what I changed, but it would have been very minor. And it may have just been putting the time and date in a second time. But the computer keeps it as.
So when you wrote that statement on April 22nd or 23rd, would it be fair to say that the events of April 18th were fresher in your mind than they are today?
Very much so, yes.
Thank you. I have no more questions.
Thank you. Cross-examination. Sure. With council scheduling of different things, we will take our lunch break now. We'll resume at 1:15. The usual instruction applies about not discussing the case among yourselves or with anyone else. And again, we'll take our lunch break at this point. We'll resume at 1:15. Thank you.
All right, see you on the jury.